Well, the international community also paying tribute to the late president. China's ambassador to the Philippines says he was deeply saddened by the news. He said Ramos was well known in China for his contributions in improving ties between Manila and Beijing. Japan's envoy also extending condolences to the Philippines following the death of Ramos, saying his leadership will never be forgotten. For U.S. Ambassador to the Philippines, Mary Kay Carlson, she will always remember Ramos for his contributions to Manila and Washington's bilateral ties. As for the European Union, it calls Ramos a dedicated statesman and a friend of the bloc. And for Germany's ambassador to the Philippines, Ramos successfully advocated for stronger Philippine-Germany trade relations, deepening the partnership of the two nations. He was fondly called Steady Eddie or Tabaco. The late president, Fidel V. Ramos, helped topple the Marcos dictatorship and steer the country to economic recovery. Here's a look back at his life and legacy.
Fidel Valdez Ramos, the country's 12th president, was a man of seeming contradictions. His presidency both exuded sternness and tenderness. A dedicated military man, he graduated from the U.S. Military Academy in West Point in 1950 and fought during the Korean and Vietnam Wars. His path would eventually take him to the helm of the Philippine Constabulary, the predecessor of the Philippine National Police, under his second cousin, former President Ferdinand Marcos. He was called a ruthless henchman as he commanded a security force that committed human rights abuses and arrested thousands of dissidents during martial law. Ramos insisted he was only enforcing law and order. But he would eventually turn his back on the dictator, becoming a key player in the people power revolt that would eventually lead to Marcos's downfall and the presidency of Corazon Aquino. Hailed as a hero of EDSA, Ramos would remain loyal to the ideals of people power as he thwarted several coup attempts as Armed Forces Chief and Secretary of National Defense, earning him the moniker Steady Eddie. He succeeded Aquino as the country's next leader in a narrowly contested election, becoming the first and only Protestant to be elected president of a predominantly Roman Catholic country. Though he won less than 24% of the vote in 1992, his approval ratings would grow steadily as the Philippines enjoyed dramatic economic growth and stability under his watch. Ramos fought right-wing, leftist, and Islamic rebels during his time in the military, but extended an olive branch to them during his presidency. His administration was best known for its Philippines 2000 program, which transformed the country from being the sick man of Asia to being cited as the region's next economic tiger. One of its key areas, energy and power generation, which allowed him to solve the power crisis he inherited from his predecessor in just 2 years. But his time in office was not without controversy. A Senate committee recommended Ramos's prosecution over the construction of the 9 billion peso Expo Pilipino in 1998. Investigative journalists claimed the project was used as a cover to raise campaign funds. But Ramos would eventually be cleared of the charges. It was also under his term that the controversial Peya Amari deal was approved, which involved billions worth of public lands along Manila Bay. Called the mother of all scams, the deal was declared illegal by the Supreme Court. Ramos saw how essential democracy and self-determination is. Yet he bowed to Indonesia and tried to prevent the first Asia-Pacific Conference on East Timor from taking place in Manila. APCAT was instrumental in drawing global attention to East Timor's struggle for independence. Ramos-era policies and laws would also later be blamed for power shortages and the high cost of electricity. He has insisted the situation was only brought about by policies and laws implemented after he had already stepped down. Ramos remained a force in Philippine politics and was instrumental in convincing Rodrigo Duterte to run for the presidency in the 2016 elections. He was appointed special envoy to China but resigned months later and criticized Duterte's performance in his first 100 days. In a statement, Malacanang says Ramos leaves behind a colorful legacy and a secure place in the country's history, one that stands for the pursuit and protection of democracy.
The Ramos family thanks the public for respecting their privacy during this most difficult time. They said they will soon announce the schedule of the former president's wake and funeral. Our deepest condolences. Historian Xiao Chua, also looking back at the life of late President Ramos, he believes one of the positive qualities of Ramos was his openness to criticism, a trait, according to Chua, that should be emulated by other presidents.
Ramos was a communicator. He was able to make a lot of people understand why he's doing such things. And I guess that is the legacy of openness to criticism and respect for the media and the institutions of the academe, for example, in telling him the criticisms. I guess that's the example that other presidents should take.
Chua points out there were some moves during the Ramos administration that received their fair share of criticism, including the amnesty granted to coup plotters.
According to some of the critics, like Ruben Carranza, he was saying that that added to the impunity because, again, you plot against the government, which is basically treason, but you only get push-up. So, you know, people eventually repeated that kind of military adventurism, which, of course, all coup d'etats, especially if not supported by the people, and, you know, if you resort to violence, only, you know, hampers the economy.